Hello, and welcome to another edition of NRF Foundation All Access. I'm Emily Chin, Vice President and General Manager of the National Client Group Retail Vertical at American Express. Every year at the NRF Foundation Honors, the NRF Foundation recognizes the list of people shaping retail's future, celebrating the dynamic individuals shaping the industry. American Express is proud to be a part of this program, and over the past 6 years, we have helped honor more than 125 extraordinary people from all corners of the retail world. We've reached out to these alumni and we've asked them to share their stories and their advice with you. In today's episode, these leaders share what they are thankful for in 2020. And what do these leaders believe 2021 will look like? Let's find out on this episode of The List, made possible by American Express.
Hi, I'm Dave Heath. I'm the co-founder and CEO of Bombas.
Hi guys, I'm Heidi Zach, co-founder and CEO of Third Love.
Hey everyone, my name is Che Huang. I'm one of the co-founders and the CEO of a company called Boxed.
Hi, I'm Susan Tynan, and I'm the founder and CEO of Framebridge.
I'm Karen Norrington Reeves. I'm the Chief Executive Officer of the Chicago Cook Workforce Partnership.
Hi, I'm James Reinhart. I'm the co-founder and CEO of ThreadUp.com.
I'm Debbie Sterling, and I'm the founder and CEO of Goldie Blocks.
Hello everyone, my name is Mosiah Bridges, and I am the CEO of Mosbo.
Hi, I'm Oliver Chen. I'm a managing director at Cowan & Company, an investment bank.
Hey everyone, I am Michael Lastoria, founder and CEO of And Pizza.
Hi, I'm Amanda Curtis. I'm CEO and co-founder of 19th Amendment and Enabled.
Hi, I'm Mary Campbell, Chief Merchandising Officer, Curate Retail Group, and Chief Commerce Officer, QVC US.
Hi, I'm Ajay Khoury. I'm one of the co-founders and chairman of the flower delivery company, Urban Stems.
In 2020, I'm thankful for the opportunity to take a pause and reassess, take that 10,000 foot view of the industry and of my own company operating within that industry and see how we can do things better.
This has been a hard year for everybody bar none, right? It's just been an incredibly hard year. But despite all of that, we're still here. We're still here. And so that means we have another opportunity to get it right. And that means we have another opportunity to celebrate the beauty.
You know, I actually did get COVID, but it thankfully it wasn't that bad. I was only sick for a month. During that time, I was forced to slow down. And I spent a lot of time kind of doing some practices that I really hadn't incorporated into my life, but always had been meaning to, like meditation. And that kind of focus inward has really helped me become a better leader.
Focus on the little things that I think we all take for granted every day. Health, I think, being, you know, first and foremost. Every day that you get out of bed and can, you know, stand on your own 2 feet is a day that you should be grateful for.
Oftentimes, as startup founders, we think, you know, we just need to be working every single hour, every single day. And if we're not pouring every single ounce of us into what we're doing, then we're letting down our employees, our investors, and our customers. What I've always kind of known but never really put importance on is that you can't pour anything out if your cup isn't full. And so this year has really been spent finding ways to fill my cup, take care of myself. What I found, which, you know, a lot of my mentors have told me for a while, and I've been not great at listening to it because it's just so easy to work harder on external things versus yourself. The better I feel, the more I have to give, the better my output is. It's something that it's hard to get through to young people. And I know that because I was the exact same way. But the earlier someone can internalize that, the better off they'll be.
I always looked forward to going to work when I was kind of building something of my own and being around the people that I really call friends and family. When it's all ripped away from you, you actually don't quite realize how much how important it really is.
I would say it's the employees of Boxed. I wake up every day and seeing all those faces, not only come into work, but to be excited to come into work throughout even the worst of the pandemic. That is something that has touched me personally. and I could probably never repay for that feeling.
I'm thankful most for our team members and the health and safety of all of our team members.
When things were getting bad, I remember every morning it's like you're kind of fingers crossed that we're doing the counts of like how many folks are going to show up to work today. Are they going to show up to work? And every day seeing the numbers being steady, even from pre-coronavirus, has been the thing professionally I've been the most thankful for.
Our ability to serve our customer and to be a place of respite for her. I think we've been able to continue to bring the joy of shopping to her and meet her where she is and meet her needs, which has been very rewarding, as well as we've been able to keep our team members' health and safety top priority along with moving the business forward. So I'm certainly really grateful for both those things.
I'm especially grateful, truly, that Framebridge gets to do something that is meaningful to people. I think 2020 is a year where people are reconsidering what is essential to them and what matters. And we've seen actually very healthy demand for what we do. People are feeling sentimental. People are reflecting on moments that mattered. People are sending thoughtful gifts to one another. And so to be in a business that does celebrate people's life highlights in a time when people are having life challenges has felt good. I think, you know, what we do still matters to people now more than ever.
In 2020, I'm so thankful that I was able to see a path forward for my business, a purpose for Goldie Blocks, a team that is so dedicated and passionate and excited about building Goldie Blocks, taking it to the next level, and really helping solve people's needs, particularly related to kids' education, digital learning, the intersection of entertainment and education. It's more timely than ever before. I'm grateful that we're still able to do that and that I'm still able to wake up every day and have my dream job.
The thing that I'm most thankful for is just being able to be alive and to create new ideas, and also being able to create new jobs throughout my community. I know there are tons of little boys and little girls that look just like me that want to do things that I do. So, you know, it's my job to help them do that.
I'm thankful for my family, friends, and colleagues, and health and wellness, and basic things around community. And I think about my loved ones and other, my significant other. And I think being healthy and having employment, I've been thankful.
What I'm most thankful for as a result of the pandemic is that I haven't been traveling at all. And I used to travel a good amount. And I think through this, I've really realized that I don't need to travel as much. And I have two young kids. And so being home more, putting them to bed every night, seeing them every morning has been really awesome for us as a family. And so that's probably what I'm most thankful for on the personal side.
I'm most thankful for the time that I've been able to spend, you know, with my family. You know, as a CEO, I travel a ton, you know, and I haven't been on a plane since early part of March. I think maybe they've seen too much of me. I think maybe now they're saying, oh, I'm like dead to go back on the road. The time that my children have been able to spend with each other, you know, since they can't spend as much time with their friends, I think they have become a lot closer and tighter as brothers and sisters. So I'm pretty grateful for that.
I'm most thankful for my family, for my amazing children, for my mom, my extended family. I'm thankful for my friends, and to just know that I'm blessed, and to be able to demonstrate that gratitude.
I think life is a lot about gratitude too, in terms of driving happiness. So I do keep a journal where I write down the three things I'm happy for weekly. And often it's about family, friends, and health.
any other year, we'd be running so fast and not forced to address some of these issues. But this year we were forced to, and you know, it's not easy. Sometimes it was very painful, but I can personally speak for my business. We're in a much, much better place on multiple levels, from sustainability to our technologies in a better place. We serve our customers better. It wasn't easy. It never is. But I'm thankful that we had the time to actually think things through and the reason to actually think things through.
I'm thankful for, you know, building a company around its workforce, having the permission to lean in to make decisions about what we would do in terms of what's best for our people in the communities, this notion of doing well by doing good. And then, of course, the cherry on top of that is being rewarded for it. I'm thankful that we had the foresight and the insight to lead with our heart, the opportunity to lead by example. The work that we've done has been replicated by so many other restaurant and retail concepts out there that I'm just so thankful that we could be a part of sparking a different way to think about things. I'm just very thankful that we were able to encourage, inspire, and to be part of something that's much bigger than ourselves. And I get really excited about leveraging what we've been able to do internally as a case study for others to learn from. And if that's all this business becomes, which is a case study that can help, you know, transcend and help move people further and further to an industry that I think we can all create together, that's good enough for me. And I think this year has taught us a lot about the fact that we can do that. We can be that for other people.
Oh, what excites me about 2021? First and foremost is that 2020 will be over. I think that's probably what everyone's thinking out there.
That 2020 will be over.
From a business perspective, I think to see how far and how much the industry will continue to change. If the pandemic, or if kind of what we went through was basically 2 weeks in nature, a month in nature, then I would admit that, you know, this surge of online traffic will probably recede back to where it was pre-coronavirus, and folks will go back to their old habit. But if you think about what's happening today, is all this online buying, for folks that didn't buy as much online before, the new habit for them is to buy online. The question shouldn't be, are they going to go back? The question should be, are they going to migrate to offline? I think will be the big question that I'm really interested to see in 2021. Because again, after a year of doing something, that's become your new habit. And so instead of saying traditionally you had to break your offline habit to go online, are folks going to break their online habit to go offline?
What excites me most in 2021, I believe, is the possibilities for the future. I feel that we've learned a lot through this pandemic as an industry. There's been a lot of innovation, a lot of reflection, and a lot of appreciation for the customer, for team members, a lot of agility in moving businesses forward, pivoting relatively quickly, and again, being very entrepreneurial in resolving business opportunities, if you will. But the innovation, I believe, that's really been generated out of this pandemic will really take us forward in 2021. And so I'm really excited about where our industry can go for the future.
There's a lot that excites me about 2021. We're going to be in a different environment of hopefully, you know, past the pandemic, where people feel safe to come out and we can start congregating in larger numbers. But I think we're going to have some of the great technologies that were, you know, pushed through in 2020 by necessity with being able to get back a little bit more to normal life. The way that looks is much better. The analogy that I've kind of been using is that, you know, after an earthquake, people rebuild with the earthquake in mind. So, you know, buildings are reinforced, everything is, the world looks different, and it's usually better. And I think that's going to happen here. We're going to rebuild in a way. The world is going to be different. The world is forever different after COVID-19. And the way that we rebuild is better. I think things are just going to be safer. There are going to be a lot more technologies that help stop the spread of diseases, that help us be more convenient, that, you know, jobs that allow more flexibility and allowing people to work from home.
Like everyone else, I'm excited for rapid testing and a vaccine.
I would love for there to be, you know, a broadly accepted and adopted vaccine that we can all come together for the greater good and recognize that the sacrifices each one of us needs to make to make sure everyone can be as healthy as humanly possible. I really much look forward to that. From a political standpoint, I think leadership that cares as much about we do about social issues, I think that's incredibly important, an opportunity to increase the federal minimum wage, an opportunity for people to feel more connected to one another. I'm looking for a lot of change in 2021, you know, hopefully for the betterment of everyone, to create a society that we're more connected, that we're all on more equal terms, and that we have all of access to healthcare and capital that we need to take care of our families and to be part of a broader community, a broader of a global community where we're all just that more in touch with and connected to one another.
2021 will be just an amazing rejoicing in the world. I think we will come to appreciate the people in our life and the human interaction and the community and the travel. I think we will just come to appreciate the world in a way that I don't think we, I think that maybe some of us started to take for granted.
I'm quite hopeful of the idea that in 2021, you know, we'll return back to a version of normal that feels more like pre-pandemic than post-pandemic. The thing that I'm probably the most excited for is getting back into the office with all of my incredible coworkers.
I'm excited about 2021 because I do think that there's an opportunity for rebirth and renewal. I think that if we take this time and use this time wisely, it's an opportunity to go within and to really gear up for the, you know, for whatever we want the next phase of our lives to be. And so I'm excited to, you know, move into a different space and to fulfill some of my dreams and goals.
I'm so excited for 2021 to see what the consumer's like. I think that the consumer is going to demand more transparency. They will want to know where their clothes and accessories and products are made, who they're made by. They're going to want to know what the environmental impact of all these products are. I just don't think that brands can hide behind supply chains. I think that the consumer is going to want access to all this information. I think this is a huge trend in 2021 is just accountability. So I'm excited to see what the consumer wants and how brands respond, and hopefully enable the 19th Amendment can be there to help those brands do that and to do that quickly. Because again, it's like creating a human experience, and part of that experience is being very transparent and truthful in every step of the ecosystem.
What I'm most excited about in 2021 is we've had a bunch of projects at Goldieblocks that we've been developing, frankly, for years. They've gotten a bit delayed, honestly, because of COVID. And so the launch is now going to be pushed for several of these projects into 2021. And so I'm so excited because we've got some new incredible products and entertainment that will be unleashed to the world that we've been working so hard on for so long and that nobody knows about. It's been maybe a blessing in disguise that things have gotten a little bit delayed because it's given us more time than we normally would have had to develop them and make them better and better. So I'm also really excited because once they do launch, I feel like they will have been really baked.
The thing that excites me about next year, new prints, new fabrics. I feel like I want to do different things with unisex clothing. Clothing that is not gender specific. I want to enter into Fashion Week, Memphis Fashion Week in 2021.
But we are continuing to open stores. So here in 2020, we have three stores where we opened. And so we're going to be rolling out probably about 10 stores next year, which is exciting. So I am looking forward to some new markets for Framebridge.
For 2021, obviously having a fresh start, I think for Third Love in particular, we have some new product launches coming that I can't really say too much about, but really excited to be launching some new categories next year. And so those are in development right now, but that'll be super exciting for our team and our community as we launch those in 2021.
There are so many things happening in 2021. I think artificial intelligence and personalization will continue to be a key theme in retail. especially as the digital transformation continues and people experience retail in new ways. We're very excited about curbside pickup at players like Walmart and Target, that being a major channel and innovative way to conduct business. We're also excited about health and wellness trends and Peloton, Planet Fitness, other stocks and ideas with respect to that. This whole changing aspect of re-commerce, whether that be rental or subscription models, will also be important in the future in our belief, and we look to see what kind of innovation happens there. Another topic is live streaming, and live streaming is really fascinating to us because it's a new channel, another way to do business in terms of live streaming shows and integrating commerce into live streams. We think that will be a major trend as well.
There's so much, you know, innovation that's come out of this, as well as, you know, the coping with the restraints that we've had during 2020 have allowed a lot of people to see what is possible. We're going to have an environment that truly caters to what consumers want and puts retailers in a position where they're going to be serving customers like they want to be served.
Thanks for joining us this fall for the list made possible by American Express. We will return in 2021 as part of the spring edition of NRF Foundation All Access. Until then, thanks for watching and for helping to shape retail's future.